Hi all, in this video I'm going to show you the easiest way to make a bootable Yosemite drive. Now most of you know there's a hidden partition on Yosemite that already has a way to boot into your operating system through it. But since a lot of you have been asking me what to do if the drive fails or if I can't boot into either partition, what should I do? This is a great backup and it can be used on multiple Macs if you do it on a thumb drive. The thumb drive that you use for this only needs to be at least 8 gigs. So what I'm going to do is first download Yosemite from the App Store. Now I already have Yosemite on my computer, but you will have to re-download it and stop it before it does the installation in order to be able to make the backup disk. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up the App Store, look for Yosemite, and hit the download button. It'll give me a question of whether or not I want to just download it, click continue, or go to the updates menu. I definitely want to hit continue to download it. Now, in this case, you're not going to run the installer, so after it completes and it downloads, you're going to want to stop it, and then we'll go to the next step. So I'm going to wait for this to download, and I'm going to find it in my apps folder once I'm done. Okay, so to continue with the setup, once OS X Yosemite has downloaded, you'll see a window like this pop up on your screen. Do not hit continue. What you're going to do is go to the install OS X menu and quit the installer. So once you've downloaded the Yosemite and you've quit out of that menu, if you want to make sure that you got the files that you needed, simply go to your applications folder and look for the file called install OS X Yosemite. If it's in there, you've done the first step right. Now let's go on to the next step. The next step would be you go to your Go menu, go to your utilities, and I'd recommend erasing the disk that you're actually going to use. Remember, you need to have a thumb drive that's at least 8 gigs. I'm using one today for 16 gigs, and here it is. I'm going to erase it just by clicking on it, going to the Erase tab, and I'm going to keep the name Untitled. It is important for us to keep the name of it to be Untitled. And I'm going to hit Erase. And Erase. And there it goes. It's unmounting the disk. It's partitioning it. It's formatting it. And it should be ready in a minute. You can watch the blue rod over here until it's done. And there you go. I have an initialized drive right here with Untitled, and we're ready to go to the next step. Quit out of the disk utility, and now stay in that same window that you're in, because now we're going to go into an application called Terminal in the same utilities folder. A lot of people are nervous about using the terminal, and yes, you can do some damage, but if you follow my instructions step by step, you should be fine. Just make sure that there's no other hard drives that are sitting on your desktop that are called Untitled, because it could create a problem when you're doing this. So the only Untitled folder that you should have, or only Untitled partition or share or hard drive that you should have mounted on your desktop, should be the one that you're actually formatting for this purpose. So go ahead and open up the terminal. Okay, so now you have your terminal window opened. You have your thumb drive named Untitled and mounted on the desktop. The next step is to simply go down to the text of this video, and depending on whether you're running Yosemite or Maverick, copy this command line. Now, this command line is for Yosemite. I'm running an operating system already on this computer for Yosemite. If I was running Maverick, I'd use the one below it. So I'm going to copy that, Command-C for copy, go into the terminal window, Command-V for paste, and hit return. Now, it's going to say, do I want to erase the disk volume? You could say yes with a Y on your keyboard and hit return. It is now going through the process of erasing it. Because this command line has the word sudo before it, you will need to have a root access account in order to run this command line. If you don't have a root access account or don't know how to set one up, don't worry. I did make a video on just that at this location, and I'll put that in the comments as well. You could stop at this point, create that root account, and then get going. If no account has ever been set up, it's very easy to be done as long as you have admin access. So once this completes, which it'll go through a process, and it does take a bit of time, and you'll see it says copying installers, etc., eventually it'll get to a window that looks like this, where it's renamed it. Wait for it to complete. It will say done, copy, complete. Once it's done, you're ready to go, and you've created a bootable disk. That's all there is to it. The root account makes it a lot easier because it only has to run one command line, as opposed to if you only have an admin account, you'll have to run these seven lines one at a time. You'll have to copy this one, paste it into the terminal window, hit return. Same with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And each of them have to be run individually. But the good part of it is, if you only have an admin account, and for whatever reason, you don't have access to the root account or can't create one, this is another avenue on how to do it. Both ways will work, but definitely the easier one is to run it with the one command line using the create install media, which is a new feature that didn't exist before Maverick. So it's really very, very cool to be able to do this with one command line and a thumb drive. So that's basically how to do it. Wait for your process to complete. As you'll see, this is running even while we're talking. It should look like this when it's complete. Well, good luck to you, and hope you enjoyed setting up a boot disk for Yosemite.